Welcome. Today is March 20th, and today we are gonna listen to DDG. What's his name? Die for Respect. DDG featuring, what's that nigga name? OG Parker. It's like a DDG and OG Parker tape. Y'all already know. But today we're gonna be reacting to it. How much songs? It got 11 songs. Not bad. Not bad. Duration is like 34 minutes or some shit like that. I like that. I'm tired of seeing 20 plus fucking songs and then like the tape is like an hour or something. It's good for some people, but not for everybody. I don't want to be hearing 20 songs from everybody. Means I want a 69 with ya, real shit. Nope. Oh, this nigga got NBA Youngboy in the first track. Oh shit, what the hell? This nigga got NBA Youngboy, Lil Yachty, Coily Ray. Ooh, I'm excited. I'm ready for that Coily Ray though. PNB Rock, Tyler Yahweh. I think that's the nigga that signed. That's the nigga who got signed by Post Malone, if I'm not mistaken. 2K Baby, I don't know who that is. 42 Doug, shit, how you get that one? And Blueface, well, that's the remix. Everybody know that one. Alright, what the fuck? This nigga listening to me. Alright, let's start off with the first track. Hood Melody featuring NBA Youngboy. They got a cock, you don't wanna get milk. If a nigga try me, I'ma put him on a shirt. High up the weed, I can't even see. We killing each other, I'm shit from the earth. If I got a big E, I keep it with me. I never been shot, but I know that it hurt. Niggas kill my brother, church. I ain't got any more. I do strong from that pain and hurt. Come around when they see me now. All these niggas just wanna see me down. Can't try me, I'ma put them on a shirt. Shawty was with me and I got a lip, but I heard she be hopping from dick to a dick. But I'm not tripping, I know how I get. I am not putting my trust in no bitch. That song was nice. It had a good message in it. You know, there's only like basically like two stereotypes for black men growing up. It's either you ball or you rap or you sell drugs. Those are the main three things that they stereotype us black people with. I'm not really too big of a fan of NBA Youngboy, but that verse was nice. I wonder how he got it though, because NBA Youngboy don't give verses to anybody, barely anybody. And I didn't know OG Parker was a rapper. OG Parker was a rapper until now. But yeah, I like that song. Hood Melody. Mm. That's the type of song I could see someone bumping in a Hellcat or like a Dodge Charger type shit. Like, you know them hood niggas? I could see them bumping that shit. No offense. Next song is Treat Me Right. Rainers, I'm on 6 feet. Ooh. I should have a bitch by my side that's gonna treat me right. Want some other shit. If I say I'm only fucking you, then fuck the other bitch. I like that song. That song was cool. I heard he fucking on Ruby Rose, so they back together now, so I hope they stay together. They're a nice couple. I see them together for a long time. Even though Ruby Rose is my wife, but you know, I let her free, I let her do her thing, you know what I mean? But yeah, every nigga gotta have a girl that will treat him right. Every nigga. And every female gotta have a nigga that'll treat her right. So it's a 50-50. Treat me right. Next song, Rule Number One, featuring Lil Yachty. Yeah, you're the one for them bitch, you can't beat me up. Rule number one, if you live in the hood, when you get rich, gotta move out the hood. I'm superstitious, I'm knocking on wood. Pray for my niggas, I hope that they good. I'm in the years, I'm doing the dance. I'm in Atlanta, I don't got no mask. I cannot fuck this shit, y'all got no ass. Cash in my pocket, it's making me sad. I don't start with this line right here. Y'all got no ass, cash, don't got no mask. I cannot fuck this shit, y'all got no ass. Cash in my pocket, it's... I seen some of the baddest bitches have no yiddies and no blubber. I'm telling you, it don't matter if they got no yiddies or no blubber. They still bad. I've seen some of the baddest bitches have nothing, but they still bad. Just the way how they walk that shit. You know what I mean? They post up with it on their Instagram and they know they got nothing, but they still post up with confidence. That's what makes them bad bitches. That's what makes you want to fuck them. Not because of the yiddies and the blubber. Hell nah. Well, that adds on to it. But when they got nothing and they still walking like they got something, make you want to do something dangerous, legally, and with their consent. Just want to state that. If you want to act up legally, Make sure they know what they doing, and you know what you doing. I ain't with that rapey vibe shit. Nah, you on your own with that one. Make sure Shawty's okay. Don't drug. Matter of fact, I'm back to the song. Out of my body, I'm smoking again. See, that's the thing. When you live in the hood, rule number one is move out the hood. What if you don't live in the hood? You live in like a nice, let's say you live in Coachella Valley or some shit. Is that the hood for you? Is that all of a sudden the hood for you now because you made it up from there? Now you gotta move to somewhere else? Because if I make it big, I mean, obviously I'm gonna plan on moving, but I don't really wanna move. Because like, if I make it big and nobody knows where I'm at, nobody knows me, I should be good. I'm not in these streets every day, standing up on a corner and some shit. Nah, nigga, I'm inside. It's 2021, we got Corona. I'm inside. Then again, summertime hitting, so I might be outside a lot more. I mean, like outside a lot more. But for real though, if nobody knows where I'm at, I'm not gonna move. I'm just saying, if nobody knows where I'm at, I'm not gonna move. If only my family knows where I'm at, I'm good with that. But if I got like 25 or 60 something friends, yeah, I'm out. I'm sorry. Y'all ain't gonna see me again. I like that song. That song was nice. Lil Yachty did his shit, even though I kind of forgot he was on the song for a minute. Yeah, I like that song. Lil Number One. Came hard on that shit. Next song is Impatient with my girl, Coilie Ray. Yes, sir. I saw that they was doing a little dance shit on Instagram Live last night, but I didn't watch it because what was I doing? I think I was on the phone. What was I doing? I was either watching some shit or I was on the phone with somebody. That's why I didn't watch through the whole thing, but it seemed like DDG and Coilie Ray are friends. That's cool. Stay away from Coilie Ray, nigga. You already got Ruby Rose. Leave Coilie Ray alone, nigga. I like that voice she be doing. That little high voice. I can't do the voice, but you know. But that little high voice she be doing on tracks, that should be fire. Take a pilot to the other, get away with you. Coilie Ray is I already know she got the highest deal in 2019 or some shit, but she's someone to watch out for real, for real. Especially now. I remember I was listening to Shawty like last year or year before. Yeah, year before. Or was it this year? I think it was this year. Earlier this year, Shawty had like 256,000 streamers a month on Spotify. 256 monthly streamers on Spotify. Shawty got over 1 million listeners now. Shawty coming up. Watch out for Coilie Ray, yo. If you're watching this, Coilie Ray, hit your boy up. Hit your boy up. You know what I mean? Next song is Get What You Want featuring PNB Rock. It's been a minute since I heard PNB Rock. Where that nigga been at? Last time I seen PNB Rock, that nigga was making a song with King Von. And he also made a song with Pop Smoke. And he waited until they died to put out the song. Both of them. looking a little bit sus there, PNB Rock. Why you putting out songs when niggas die? Why you be finishing the song at like 2 minutes and 30 seconds, but the song is actually 3 minutes? What the hell is wrong with these niggas, bro? Oh, wait a minute. That's why. Oh, that's cool. You get what you want. I like that song. It was cool. I miss PNB Rock though. I need another album from PNB Rock. He's been gone for too long, album wise. But single wise, I guess he's been still kind of relevant. And the next song is Where You Talk. Blessing, just come in my direction. Please don't stop undressing. You come first, I come second. I got your bag out of Louis. Alpha came from Gucci. Before the fame, you knew me. Promise I'm not bougie. I wanna beat it up. Stay in the sheets when you fuckin' with me. Call the mason and clean it up. See bad on the gram, baby, keep it up. I don't wanna blow your phone, so I ease it up. I was quiet back then, I was speaking up. I ain't wanna fall in love, but it's speaking up. I wanna see you get naked. Just give me a second, I'm finna come through. I thought this nigga was gonna come with OG Parker. Nah, I know he's gonna come with OG Parker, but I thought this nigga was gonna come with like a whole tape with Moonwalking and Calabasas type songs. Like, damn, what kind of songs are those? Just like straight like hype, and you know, like you wanna, I don't know, like damn. Moonwalking in Calabasas is like, what? I don't know, it's a hype song, it gets you hype, I guess. But I thought he was gonna come with like 12 of those type shits. This nigga making love songs up in this bitch. He's good at it, I ain't gonna lie. I like that one. Why, Where You Talk, I like that one. Next song is Hakuna Matata. I had to get close to read that one. Niggas making Lion King songs. I could be evil, so don't even bother. I'm not with the drama, got too many commas. Not worried about nada, I'm grew on my diet. Back in the day, I was broke with no dollar. Now I got Gucci all over my collar. I do this for the day. I get Juice WRLD vibes from this kid. I'm sorry. The way I heard this nigga singing sounds like Juice WRLD, low key. Like the flow. And I'm not saying his voice sounds like Juice WRLD. I'm saying that the flow, like the shit, sounds like Juice WRLD. Now it's home and stop. Back in the day, I was bumping on. You know those songs where they say, like, oh, it would be better without this feature? This is one of those songs. I'm not gonna lie. I'm sorry, Tyler Yahweh. I'm not trying to fuck up your money or anything, or say you trash or anything, but this one of them songs that DDG was already going so nice on that he could have completed the whole song just doing the same shit, just saying the same shit. It don't even matter. Just put like an extra verse in there, put a hook, and then end the song right there. He didn't really need to put Tyler Yahweh in this shit, to be honest. I could see DDG doing this song all by himself. This song would have been better all by himself, to be honest, but it's good. Let Him Go featuring 2K Baby. I don't know 2K Baby. I think I probably heard him once, but I don't know him, like, know what he looks like type shit. Good on this, A Boogie was solid. This is an A Boogie song right here, dog. Then I got it, babe, right on time. Baby, little bitch, I bought the whole house. Baby, skin freaky, and that bitch,
seems the whole mouth. I cannot cuddle after sex, I gotta roll out. Let these bitches go.
Some of y'all niggas need to do that. Let them bitch go.
So bring them to me.
Nah, I'm just playing. Next song, Money Long featuring 42 Doug. This shit gotta be fire.
I'ma send your ass to Miami for a tummy tuck. Boom, boom. Hit his legs, watch him walk it out. You was playing tough, why the fuck you wanna talk it out? I just caught a nigga lacking at the Waffle House. Niggas know I'm dripping hella stupid when I'm popping out.
After call me, you can die again. Just say I can drive again. Fuck, I got these whips for. Plug to send me 5 on my son, send me 6 more. I travel with blush cause I'm my son. You can get smoke, pass the weed. My nigga, pass the bins.
I got this weed in my lungs and this shit dope.
That's
don't
it?
Bring your bitch wrong enemy. Hit a nigga bitch and I got her eyes rolling back. Million off the gag. Ain't no fucking way I'm going back, bitch. Mm.
Yes, sir. I'm fucking that nigga. He fucking his shit on that one. I'm fucking that one. Money one. He's fucking his shit. I fuck with that song. Yes, sir. 42 Doug. I wish his verse was longer, but, you know, I guess it was pricey. That song was fire. I need security. Tell that to Pooh Shiesty.
I need security. I feel a nigga to roll with a mess, so I don't have scrap. City and trying to get you, you know how I'm at. She wanna fuck with the condom, I'm hitting her back and I'm ripping her bonnet off. I bust a nut and I wander off. We gon' get freaky as soon as the camera off.
I bust a nut and I wander off.
Fuck till I run out of stuff.
I'm scared.
Don't fuck with nobody, period. We can just cuddle when she on her period. I'ma just be hella horny and furious. I am a dog.
You need security to pull up the shorty crib. That's what you're telling me. I don't know about that one, bro. This late night, ain't nobody stalking you? Well, then again, you never know. But if you going to like the mall or some shit, alright. You need security, nigga. And that was it. Well, except for the moonwalking in Calabasas, which everybody knows.
Stupid can't fuck that shit. And you know I hold that shit. Mama told you we gon' be okay. Whipping the bitch, she living in.
I heard recently that this nigga was dissing, what's that nigga name? I forgot his name. But he was dissing somebody in this song. I didn't even know. I thought he was just moonwalking in Calabasas. I didn't know it was a diss song.
If we beef, I fuck your bitch. All of them niggas are on the internet. I hit up all of them bitches and get them wet. Call her over.
It?
I hit them and send them back. Doing it. Silence is players. Ain't internet. No, I hit this bitch on the low.
That's it.
She said your dick was so. And she told me you broke.
That's it. I think I got the diss parts. I think I got it. That's the part where he was talking about I fuck your bitch and all that other shit. That has to be the diss parts. I thought he was just saying that to say that because, you know, it's a rapper shit to say, and then not knowing this nigga was talking to a whole other YouTuber. Found that shit out like last week before the album dropped. Like, wait a minute, hold up, this nigga was dissing somebody? Because he was on Twitch with Academics, and Academics brought it up, and I was so confused. I was like, wait a minute, he was dissing somebody? How the fuck? But yeah, that was DDG and OG Parker. I think it's his first tape. Die for Respect, let me see. Oh no, it's not his first tape. Damn, what the fuck? It's not his first tape, never mind. How much moonwalking in Calabasas remix he got? He got 1, 2, 3, 4, and then he got the Blueface one. 5. Yeah, that shit was fire. That shit was fire. I like that shit. I rate that album, since this is the first time I've ever actually like actually listened to DDG. Cause I never watched his YouTube videos either. I didn't come up with DDG. I'm sorry. I just found out about DDG. I don't know when I found out about him, but I just watched like my first DDG full YouTube video last year when coronavirus hit. Cause I was so bored, I didn't know what else to do. My favorite YouTubers wasn't posting. DDG was, you know, always been a popping YouTuber, so I was like, you know what, let me watch some of his videos. And he always got the baddest bitches on the YouTube videos, so I was like, you know, let me check him out. So yeah, first time I ever watched his videos was last year. So I'm new to the DDG. I'm not a YouTube fan, sorry to say. But I'm a fan now of his music, not YouTube. Well, YouTube, but music. I'll rate this album, I would say, I'll give him a 6 out of 10. 6, 7 out of 10. 7.5, 6, 7. I can never come down to one number. It's always between two numbers. I'll give him 6. 6.5, 7. 7.5, 7. 7 kind of high. 7 kind of high. You know what? Yeah, 7. Because 7. I'll give him a 7 for this album. This album was a good album. Or mixtape, whatever it is. The features was good. The songs was good. I mean, I like that one song where I feel like he could have been by himself, which was the Hakuna Matata. I think he could have been by himself on that one. It would have been fire. But other than that, I like this whole project. Short, nice. You know what I mean? Not like a 20-track album type shit. Pretty good, pretty good. Pretty good. I heard he's on like number one. Like the Apple charts or some shit like that. But I hope he moves good. I hope he does good with this shit. I'm gonna look out for him. I don't know what I expect from him next. I mean, obviously another album or singles and shit like that. But I hope he make another hit or some shit. I don't know if he might hook up with Blueface again, make another hit. I don't know. But that Calabasas, Moonwalking the Calabasas remix, that shit was fire. Damn, could that be the song of the summer? I mean, it's old, but people still bumping it. I still bump it. I don't know. But yeah, I fuck with DG, I fuck with the album. I fuck with him and Ruby Rose, even though that kind of hurts, but you know, gotta move on, gotta move on. Yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching.